Good morning, students. Today you are going to learn about a new chapter 2, Unit 7, Genetics. I hope you all know about genetics in lower section. In 10th standard, you already studied about genetics and Mendel's classes. So, what does mean by genetics? Genetics is the study of how living things reproduce common traits. Traits means characters from previous generation, that means from their parents to their offsprings. The transmission of characters from their parents to their offspring is called as an inheritance. So genetics is the study of inheritance of characters. And what does mean by genetics? Genetics is the study of inheritance of characters from one generation to the next generation. So genetics is useful in many fields, such as agriculture, medicine, and forensic science. So the study of genetics is helpful in different branches of biology, such as agriculture, medicine, and forensic science. So genetics means the science of heredity. Heredity means inheritance. Genetics is the branch of biological science which deals with the mechanism of transmission. Transmission means the character passes from one generation to the next generation. So transmission of characters from parents to offsprings. Offspring means young ones. What is meant by offsprings? Offsprings means young ones. The term genetic was introduced by W. Batson in 1906. So the term genetics was introduced by W. Batson in 1906. So the four major disciplines of genetics are transmission genetics, molecular genetics, population genetics, quantitative genetics. What are the four major disciplines of genetics? Transmission genetics, molecular genetics, population genetics, and quantitative genetics. Now we are going to learn one by one. So first is transmission genetics, are also called as classical genetics, which deals about the transmission of genes, that is the transfer of genes from parents to their offsprings. So the characters are transferred from parents to their offsprings through the genetic DNA. Through the genetic, the transmission of characters are passed from one generation to the next generation. So the foundation of classical genetics came from the study of heredity behavior of 7 genes by Gregor John Mendel. So Gregor John Mendel selected 7 pairs of contrasting characters in pea plant. I hope that you all know about the 7 pairs of contrasting characters. You already studied in 10th standard. What are the 7 pairs of contrasting characters of pea plant which was chosen by Gregor John Mendel? The next one is molecular genetics. The molecular genetics deals with the structure and function of genes at molecular level. So at molecular level, at DNA level, how the structure and functions of genes occur, it is called as a molecular genetics. The next is population genetics. The population genetics deals with the heredity in group of individuals for traits. Traits means character, which is determined by a few genes. Only few genes are involved in the determination of characters in population genetics. For example, sickle cell anemia is caused by a mutation of one of the genes responsible for the production of hemoglobin. Individuals with the 2 copies of mutant genes for sickle hemoglobin develop the disease sickle cell anemia. So sickle cell anemia is an example for the population genetics. In sickle cell anemia is caused by a mutation of the gene responsible for the production of hemoglobin. I hope that you all know about hemoglobin. Hemoglobin means a red pigment which is responsible for the red color of the blood. So the individuals with the 2 copies of mutant, instead of normal gene, the mutated gene makes the sickle hemoglobin. It develops the disease sickle cell anemia. So it is an example for population genetics. The next, quantitative genetics. The quantitative genetics deals with heredity of traits, that is character, in a group of individual, where the traits, that is characters, are governed by many genes simultaneously. Here the many genes are involved in the formation of a single character. For example, for quantitative genetics are height, weight and blood pressure of the human. Here there is no single gene is responsible for the height and weight. So this height, weight of the individual and blood pressure are controlled by the several genes simultaneously. It is called as a quantitative. Here more number of genes are responsible for the formation of a single trait. So it is called as a quantitative genetics. The example for quantitative genetics are height of the human being, weight of the human being and blood pressure. It's about the quantitative genetics. Then next topic is heredity and variation. The genetics is also described as a science that deals about the heredity and variation. Heredity. The heredity is referred as the transmission of characters from parents to offspring. Mostly the transmission of familiar character from parent to their offsprings. Offspring means young ones. So the transmission of characters from parents to offsprings, that is similar characters. The next, variation. The organism belongs to the same natural population or species that shows a difference in their character is called as variation. Variation means the differences shown by the individuals of same species is called as a variation. So the variation is a different characters which are shown by the young ones which are born from the same parent, or the different character which is seen in the offspring which is not present in their own parent is called as a variation. So it is the different characters seen in the young ones which is not present in their own parent is called as a variation. So the variation is classified into two types. One is a discontinuous variation, another one is a continuous variations. There are two types of variations are seen in the individuals. One is discontinuous variation and continuous variation. The next topic is discontinuous variation. So in discontinuous variation, within the population there are small characters which shows a limited form of variation. So here the young one shows only the limited form of variation, that is differences, is called as a discontinuous variation. The discontinuous variation is distinct features. It is a distinct, very small changes only occurs in the individual is called as a discontinuous variation. For example, the discontinuous variation is style length and primula. In primula, there are two type of style lengths are present. One is longer style, another one is a shorter style. Only in between the long and the short style, there is no any size of styles are present. Only one is a long length of the style and short length of the style is only present. So here only a few individuals are present. So small differences that exist between the individual is called as a discontinuous variation. And plant height of the garden pea. So the plant height of the garden pea is also an example for discontinuous variation. In discontinuous variation, the characteristics are controlled by one or two major genes. Here only one genes are one or two genes are present in the discontinuous variation, which have two or more allelic forms. These variations are genetically determined by inheritance features, that is the inheritance factors, inheritance genes makes this variation. The individuals produced by the variation shows differences without any intermediate form between them, and there is no overlapping between the two phenotype. What is meant by phenotype? The external appearance of an individual is called as a phenotype. So for example, in garden pea plant, the height of the plant is, one is a tall plant, another one is a short plant. That is, tall and short are the phenotypic characters. So the phenotypic expression is unaffected by environmental condition. This is also called as qualitative inheritance. That is, the discontinuous inheritance is also called as a qualitative inheritance. The example for the discontinuous variation is blood group in human being. There are only four types of blood groups are occurring in human being. That is, A blood group, B blood group, AB blood group and O blood group. Here only small differences shown between the individual is called as a discontinuous variation. The discontinuous variation means some characters which shows a limited form of variation. Here only limit form of variations are occur. This variation is controlled by one or two major genes. This variation is controlled by only one or two major genes which have two or more alleles, allelic forms, which have two or more allelic forms. So the variation are genetically determined by inheritance factor only. Inheritance means only the transmission factors from their parents to their offsprings only determine the discontinuous variation. So the individuals produced by this variation shows differences without any intermediate forms. Here in between A and B blood group or A blood group, there is no any intermediate are present. So it is called as a discontinuous variation. So this discontinuous variation is also not affected by environmental conditions. So here there is no overlapping of individuals between the two phenotypes. The next variation is a continuous variation. The continuous variation is a variation may be due to combining effect of both environmental and also genetic factors. So here this variation is caused by due to environmental factor and also genetic factor. In a population, most of the characteristics exhibit a complete gradation from one extreme to the other extreme without any break. Inheritance of phenotype is determined by the combined effect of many genes. Here the many genes are involved in the continuous variation. So the continuous variation is also called as polygenes, and it is affected by environmental factor. This is also known as quantitative inheritance, because here more number of genes are involved in the formation of a single character, a single trait. So it is called as a quantitative inheritance. The example for continuous variations are human height and also skin color. The height of the person and the weight of the person ranges from that of the short person in the world to that of the tallest person. So any height is possible between the two extremes, between the shortest and the tallest. In between the shortest and tallest, many heights are possible. Between the short and the tallest values, so it is a continuous. Here in between the two extremes, there is a continuous values are present. So it is called as a continuous variation. The example for continuous variation is height of the person and also skin color of the person. And this continuous variation is controlled by many genes, are also called as polygenic variation. This is called as a polygenic variation. So next is importance of variation. The importance of variation is also a very important 3-mark question. So the importance of variation, the variation makes some individuals better fitted to the struggle for existence. I hope you all know about survival of the fittest and struggle for existence. So the individuals makes themselves to better suit with the existing environment is due to variation. This variation causes the individual to fit with the environmental condition, any environmental condition. It is called as the individual better fitted to the struggle for existence. That is, they help the individuals to adapt themselves to the changing environment. The variation which makes the individual better suit with the changing environment. So it makes the individual adapted to any type of environmental condition. It provides the genetic material for natural selection. So the variations makes the individual to provide the genetic materials for natural selections. So variation allow breeders to improve better yield. So the due to variation, the individual gives more better yield and quicker growth and increased resistance and lesser input. So the resistivity power is also increased due to variation. Compared to the normal plant, the variated plant may grow quicker and also the yield is more compared to the normal plant. So they constitute the raw material for evolution. So the variation also plays an important role for the formation of evolution. Evolution means a gradual change occur in an organism from a simpler to the more complex. So the variations makes the individual better suited to the changing environmental condition, and also it serves as a raw material for the formation of new individuals or new species through evolution. The next topic is Mendelism. The contribution of Mendel to genetics is called as Mendelism. The contribution of Mendel to genetics is called as Mendelism. Mendelism includes all the concept brought out by Mendel through his original research on plant hybridization. So the hybridization means the mixing of two different characters or two different species is called as hybridization. So the concept which was proposed by Mendel through his work is called as Mendelism. The Mendelian genetic concept are the basic for the modern genetics. So the Mendel's works are the basic for the formation of modern genetics. Therefore, the Mendel is called as a father of genetics. I hope you all already know about the Mendels. The Mendel is called as a father of genetics. The next, we are going to learn about the biography of Gregor John Mendel. So the father of genetics, Gregor John Mendel, the father of genetics, he was born on 22nd July in 1822 in Essendorf, Silesia in Austria. After his school education, he studied botany, physics and also mathematics at the University of Vienna. He then entered a monastery of St. Thomas at Bern in Austria and continued his interest in plant hybridization. In 1849, Mendel got a temporary position in a school as a teacher, and he performed a series of elegant experiments with pea plant. He done many experiments with a garden pea plant, that is Pisum sativum, in his garden. In the year 1856, he started his historic studies on pea plant. In 1856 to 1863 was the period of Mendel's hybridization experiment on garden pea plant, that is Pisum sativum. Mendel discovered the principles of heredity by studying the inheritance of 7 pairs of contrasting characters of pea plants. I hope you all know about the 7 pairs of contrasting characters of pea plant. In 10th standard, you already studied about the 7 pairs of contrasting character in garden pea plant, which was chosen by Gregor John Mendel. Mendel crossed and cataloged 24,034 species plants through many generations. His paper entitled as Experiments on Plant Hybridization. With this experiment, he make paper entitled Experiments on Hybrid Plant Hybrid was presented and published in the Proceedings of the Bern Society of Natural History in the year 1866. Mendel was the systematic researcher in the field of genetics. He was a systematic researcher in the field of genetics. Next, the important topic, Mendel's success. What was the reasons for Mendel's success? An important question. So Mendel, the reason for Mendel's success is he applied mathematics and statistical method to biology and laws of probability to his breeding experiment. His work was in the field of mathematics and statistics to biology, and also he applied the law of probability in the breeding experiment. He followed a scientific method and kept accurate and detailed record that include quantitative data of the outcome of his crash. He used accurate and detailed record that include the quantitative data of the pea plants, so the individual plants. His experiments were carefully planned and he used large sample. At a time, he used large number of sample plants for his experiment. The pairs of contrasting characters which were controlled by factors, that is now it is called as a genes, which was factor was called by a Mendel, so, were present on separate chromosomes. So the contrasting pairs which control the genes or factors were present on separate chromosomes. The plants selected by Mendel were mostly pure breed lines. Pure breeding means many number of generation it produces only one type of individual is called as a pure breeding, pure lines. To the purity was tested by self-crossing the progenies for many generations. Self-crossing means a self-pollination or self-fertilization. Self-fertilization or self-pollination makes the progenies for many generations. Progeny means the young ones. So the parents selected by Mendel were mostly pure breeds. Pure breed means if we cross many number of generation, it produces only one type of individuals is called as a pure breed lines. And the purity was tested by, how the purity was tested by Mendel? By self-crossing the progeny for many generations. The young ones which are born by the pure breeding parents are again self-crossed and produces many generations. So these are the reasons for Mendel's success. So the reasons for Mendel's success, he applied mathematical and also statistical methods to biology and the law of probability to his breeding experiment. So he recorded everything in as a detailed the experiment were carefully planned and he used large samples, more number of plants are used for his experiment. And the contrasting characters which control a factor are present on separate chromosomes. The parents selected by Mendel were all are pure breed lines and the purity was tested by self-crossing their progenies.